Hi, I'm Phil Hadland, Curator of Natural Sciences and Archaeology at Hastings Museum and Art Gallery. In the What's in a Box project, I worked with homeschooling families to document natural science collections and develop creative outputs with them. So I hope you like the talk and look forward to answering any questions. What's in the Box is a museum collections-based community engagement project. In the first strand, home educating families help the museum to document its natural science collections. The project is funded through an Arts Council National Lottery project grant. At the beginning of the project, participants were invited to explore the galleries and create kaleidoscopic patterns using the displays. Each home education student received their own box of kit, which would be used to document the objects. They used their kaleidoscope patterns and recycled old magazines to decorate their boxes and their journals. The participants documented and photographed hundreds of objects during the project. They also completed creative activities, including making stop-motion animations inspired by their favourite objects. Participants also had the opportunity to learn from professional taxidermist Jasmine Miles Long about the process of preserving animal specimens.
My daughter was really inspired by Jasmine Miles Long, the ethical taxidermist, and particularly enjoyed meeting Brian the Fox. On our final trip to the museum, she created a little stop motion clip of two foxes playing under a Christmas tree.
The exhibition, hosted on online platform ArtSteps, includes creative outputs from the participants, which include posters and poems. Hi, so that video basically covers the activity that happened once lockdown restrictions were lifted at the end of the summer holidays in 2020 through till the spring when we opened the exhibition. But obviously there was a lot of work that went on before that, and what we had hoped to do to recruit participants was have sessions at the museum whereby we would put on some activities that would simulate the sorts of things that they'd be doing in the project. But obviously we weren't able to do that because of COVID-19. So we had some virtual activities, and one of which was Rock Around Hastings, whereby we invited participants to document rocks that they were finding in their natural environment or their back gardens and do the sort of curatorial process with those rocks. So we were of course limited by the restrictions when we started sessions in the museum, so social distancing of course, and we weren't able to have large teams and no production lines were possible. And of course we had a limited number of participants for each session, so this meant greater numbers of sessions needed to make the numbers that we needed. But the benefits of this were that participants got more beneficial engagement from staff. Parents very positive about the museum sessions, both for their children and for themselves. They reported that exploring the boxes and touching the various objects was exciting, magical, and had sparked an interest in research. One parent noted that there were particular benefits for children in terms of providing them with meaningful experiences of a world of work, as well as providing opportunities to learn in a calm, personalised environment. Not being able to have a physical exhibition during the Project Strand exhibition window has left us with an underspend. We are planning to use this money to run creative workshops inspired by the marine biology collections for more families who have been homeschooling due to the lockdowns, as a kind of creative arts catch-up. We will share the outputs from this later in the year,